That's right, Atlanta. Say now, number 7, shortstop Kenny Stanisek. Center fielder number 2, Will Albert. Left fielder number 5, Reedy Pride. First baseman number 32, Zach Lucia Nicholsmore. The designated hitter number 22, Shane Ward. The catcher for the day, number 20, Lee Parker. Left fielder number 17, Hunter Zentz. Third baseman, number 35, Colton Roots. Second baseman, number 3, Mason Lee. And the man on the mound, number 16, Zach Mark. Your Pirates are coached by Mr. Ben Fox and Ryan Johnson. Ladies and gentlemen, if you would remove your hats and rise and direct your attention to center field, we honor our nation and those who serve by the playing of the national anthem.
Who's back? Back again. Chris Brown's back. Tell your friends. Guess who's back? Guess who's back? Guess who's back? Welcome back, Chris.
Welcome back. Glad to be back. Sorry for the last couple of weekends. Had some other commitments I had to take care of, but hopefully we've gotten all that taken care of now. I get to come to baseball today. Chris Brown here with the Hall of Famer, Mike Ward.
I moved from famous to Hall of Famer.
Wow. Welcome, everybody, into the live stream today as your ECU Pirates take on the NC State Wolfpack. Number 1, number 3 matchup today. And I wasn't here yesterday, but checking the online stream while I was DJing a wedding, I see we're in for a bit of a rubber match today.
Yeah, 2-game split yesterday. You could tell two competitive ball clubs. Pitching was very well. Defense played very well. One inning yesterday tripped up the Pirates. They ended up costing them in the first game. Lost the first one 4-3. And in the second game, it looked like a blowout. But the Pirates only put up 6 in the first. And the Wolfpack brought in a left-hander there and didn't score again for the rest of the game. So big one inning by the Wolfpack in the first game. Big one inning by the Pirates in the second game. Let's see what happens here in the rubber match.
So we're getting ready to get underway here. Those of you watching out there, be sure to check in. Let us know where you're watching from and who you're cheering for. We welcome any NC State fans and welcome our Pirate fans as usual. And here we go as we get underway. Leading things off for the Wolfpack.
The center fielder, number 13, Jacob Annunziata.
Wasn't going to mess that up. First pitch in there for a strike. Your defensive alignment for your Pirates. Starting on the bump, number 16, Zach Warwick. His battery mate behind the plate, number 20, Lee Parker. As he comes set for the 0-1, pops it foul and out of play. That'll bring the count 0-2. First baseman, number 32, Zach Rooster Nicholson. Second base, number 3, Mason Lee. Third base, number 35, Colt Motes. Shortstop, number 7, Jay Stanisek. As the next pitch misses outside, 1-2 the count. Moving left to right, number 5, Petey Fry. In center field, number 2, Will Albert. And in right field, rounding things off, number 17, Hunter Zintz. The 1-2 offered, catches the outside corner for a leadoff strikeout.
Big pitch there by Zach. It's important for the Pirates to get off to a good start today. The Wolfpack really took advantage in both first innings yesterday. I believe he scored runs in both first innings of both games. So really important for Zach to throw up a zero here.
Next at the bat for the Wolfpack, who we got here?
We've got the right fielder, number 12, Jake Montgomery.
And he'll take a hit by pitch right on the left shoulder. And that'll put the first runner on for the Wolfpack here in the top of the first with one away.
It's going to bring up the first baseman, number 26, Reese Landmark. Reese hitting 314 on the season. I believe this was the one that had the big swing yesterday, big three-run home run to give the Wolfpack the lead that they would not relinquish.
Runner on first gets his lead as Rooster holds him on over there. Work comes set. Pick attempts. That was close. Just did get back in time.
Big difference today is the wind, or lack thereof. Wind was gusting 15 to 20 yesterday. The flags are not flapping at all today.
That pitch misses somewhere for a ball. 1-0 is the count. And we do have the center field camera, but like everything else, it was working great for 2 hours and then started freezing up on me. So. The 1-0 misses inside. Throw down to second on the money. Did he get him? Yes, he did. Two away. Great throw by Parker behind the plate to, I believe that was Stanisek that put the tag on. So that'll empty the bases. 2-0 the count here.
We talked about the Pirates starting hot. Opportunity now to go 3-3 down in the first inning.
Nice pitch at the knees. 2-1 the count.
Zach on the year, a 3-0 record, 16.1 innings pitched with a 3.31 ERA and 15 Ks.
Did he offer? They're going to say he did not. 3-1 the count here.
So about a K an inning for Zach, so he's really going to rely on his defense.
Pitch home. And that'll miss inside for ball 4. Now to put another runner at first. 2 away here in the top of the first.
It's going to bring up the DH, number 15, Reed Richards. He is currently the leading hitter on the team, or at least in this lineup, with a 4.04 average.
Just under my college average.
About 400 points higher than my college GPA.
Oh, that one will catch the outer half for a strike. 0-1's the count.
Already have J.J. Tillery and Tammy Bunch in the chat. Glad to have you guys join us. Tammy, a regular here, checking out her nephew, Shea Ward.
That one misses low. That'll even things up. One ball, one strike. Rooster holding the runner at first. And nice breaking ball. Got him to chase bottom. Just fell out of that one. That'll move to count 1-2. Good crowd here at Guy Smith Stadium. The 1-2. Misses low. Throw down to second off the mark. And that'll put a runner in scoring position for the Pack.
Tough pitch for Parker to handle there. Just a little off on the throw down to second. Zach still way ahead.
And rings him up on the inside corner. 1-2-3.
Chris, I've been practicing. Why do you not eat aluminum?
Why?
Because you might sheet metal.
It's going to be that kind of day. We'll be back. No score. We go to the bottom of the first. You're watching ECU Club Baseball here on the ECU Club channel. We'll be back right after this. at his battery mate behind the plate. 0-1 the count here in the bottom of the first to lead things off. Let's try this camera and see if it's working. Fouls that one back and out of play. And that'll move to count 0-2.
Stosky 3-0 on the year, 18.1 innings pitched, a 1.53 ERA and 32 Ks on the season. So just about two strikeouts an inning. So unlike Warwick, Stosky really relies on the Ks.
The 0-2. That one missed just in the river. Just off the plate there. 1-2 the count.
2 7-inning games yesterday. Today will be a 9-inning affair.
And he'll ring him up on that one as that one caught the outer half. One away. That will bring up the center fielder, number 2, Will Albert. He'll dig in from the left side, so a righty-lefty matchup this time. Mostowski comes set, pitch home. Fouls it back and out of play. 0-1 the count.
Mostowski working ahead to the first two batters.
And 0-1. Drills that one into right field, right to the right fielder, number 12, Jake Montgomery, and he'll put it away for out number 2. So with two up and two down, that'll bring up your left fielder, number 5, Petey Fry.
Good to see Petey back yesterday in the lineup. Had an injury in the Elon series, missed the South Carolina series and the Wilmington series, so certainly good to have him back.
Petey digs in from the right side, righty-righty matchup, two away, nobody on. Pitch misses outside for a ball, 1-0's the count. Your defensive alignment for the Wolfpack, let's try to get that in here. Third base on the hot corner, number 8, Chadwick Carpenter. Shortstop, number 18, Michael Weaver. Second base, number 24, Mason Bay. And first base, number 26, Reese Landmark. And that pitch is in there for a strike. Moving left to right, number 29, John Constantino in left field, center field, number 13, Jacob, say that again for me.
Annunziata.
And right field, number 12, Jake Montgomery. That's your defensive alignment for the Wolfpack. The 1-1 pops it up deep right center. Jake will range over, make the grab, and three up, three down go the Pirates. No score. Here at Guy Smith Stadium, Greenville, North Carolina. We go to the top of the second. You're watching ECU Club Baseball here on New. That one in there for a strike on the outer half. My camera's messing up again. We'll switch back out of that. That'll even the count, 1-1. and tipped foul. And Wark will be able to work ahead in the count. 1-2.
Louise, I can say this one is not the one that you're looking for. Gray pants, blue jerseys do not ring a bell.
Drills that one right center. Albert makes the grab. One away.
Catcher Jake Wingard now batting for the Wolfpack, hitting 273 on the season.
Chases one as the bottom fell out of it as it got to the plate from Warwick there. 0-1 the count here. Not much wind here at the stadium. Foul tipped. 0-2. A lot warmer than the last game I was here.
A lot warmer than the last game. Same breeze yesterday. He's rolling, blowing from left field to right, not dead in, but it was certainly chilly in the shade.
Now when sells high and inside, that'll make the count 1-2.
I don't mind that as an 0-2 pitch at all. Good location there.
The 1-2 offer from Wark. Breaking ball and a little check swing there. Got a piece of it.
He may have gone around there wise not to check because he would have been on first base easily.
Ward's got what he wants, the 1-2 offer. And gets him to chase, drop third. They'll throw it down to first. 2-A.
Next up for the Wolfpack is the second baseman, number 24, Mason Bay. Mason coming in at 167 on the season.
Mason digs in from the right side. Righty-righty matchup. Pitch home. Healthy cut comes up empty. One's the count.
Good spot there by Wart.
So what I say about the name Mason, because my son's named Mason. You holler that at a ballpark and 40 people turn around and look at you. He comes up empty once again. 0-2. Pitch home. Just missed. Wark wanted that one. So did half the infield.
Yeah, the entire right side, including the right fielder, was heading to the dugout on that one.
The 1-2. Pops it up a mile high. And lost in the sunlight, it looked like.
Yep, Colton never really had a shot at it. He lost it when it got up above the stadium and could never find it.
Sun is right there. We'll give him a break on that.
Thankfully, he does not have sunglasses on top of his hat.
As that one misses for a ball, that'll even things up 2-2.
Nothing tears an old dad up worse than a guy going to catch a fly ball and the sunglasses on top of the player's head.
Comes up empty. 1-2-3. Go the Wolfpack. Still no score here in Greenville. We go to the bottom of the second. You're watching Pirate Baseball here on the ECU Club Channel. We'll be back right after this.
of you watching. Let's try to double that. Hit that like, hit that subscribe, hit that share button. Let's get everybody out there in the streaming land watching a quality baseball game today.
That'll catch the bottom part of the zone. That'll even the count, 1-1. I feel like I missed some really good baseball yesterday. The doubleheader, they split, and Rooster drills that one back up the middle for a base knock. And he'll get things started here.
You can see Ostrowski's game plan. He's trying to live on that outside corner. Really nothing over the middle of the plate. Zach was able to drive that right back up the middle.
Hey, I'm a Greg Maddux fan, too. I get it. Love it. Who does this bring up here?
This brings up the DH, number 22, Shea Ward, hitting 424 on the season.
Rooster with a small lead at first base. Pitch in for a strike. 0-1's the count. So good news. I know what's wrong with the center field camera.
Oh, good news.
Bad news. I got to find time to log in and fix it. The 0-1. That'll miss low. That'll even things up. 1-1. That broke, not in time. 2-1's the count.
Maybe stayed a little up.
I feel like it broke right on the back part of the plate. High enough. Good call. The 2-1. And that'll miss low, and Shea way ahead. 3-1 the count.
This is one of those where you really want him to see the pitch out of the pitcher's hand, not just say, I'm going to swing, because it's a 3-1 count. Really has a chance to do some damage here.
And the pitch home. Thought about it, lays off, and
Just a little bit off the plate there, but now he knows the zone, hopefully, so got a battle.
3-2 count, payoff pitch. And stays alive as he fouls that one off.
Healthy cut there, too.
That'll send the catcher out to give the umpire a break as they walk in to check on him. I think he caught that one off the arm there. Not sure if the catcher got any off of him as well. Yeah, good to be back. I didn't tell you this. I did get fired from my full-time job.
What did you do
this week at the orange juice factory?
At the orange juice factory?
Yeah. I got canned. Said I couldn't concentrate.
Oh, God. It just keeps going.
They really put the squeeze on me.
Oh, no.
He pops that one up deep. Center fielder will range in and make the grab for out number one. That'll send Rooster back to first. One away.
It's going to bring up your catcher. Number 20, Lee Parker, hitting 353 on the year.
He'll dig in from the right side. Rooster at first. One away. Pitch home. And he went around on that one, and he knew he shouldn't have two with that look. The 0-1. Comes up empty.
Tiffany Alderson, as always.
Please don't encourage us.
We're appreciating the comedy.
Oh, high heat comes up empty. Three pitches, three strikes, two away.
Let's bring up your right fielder, number 17, Hunter Zentz, batting 395 on the season.
I played this song, Hunter's walk-up song, some Akon. I played this song at my wedding last night.
Nice. Good response.
And I thought about Zentz when I did it. Pitch home, misses low and away. 1-0 is the count. Rooster dancing off of first, known for his lightning speed. Pirates trying to get him into scoring position. The 1-0 offer. And catches the lower part of the zone. That'll even things up, 1-1. Pitch home. Right back up the middle to the shortstop. He'll toss to second. And the Pirates leave one stranded. We go to the top of the third. Still no score here in Greenville. You're watching Pirate Baseball here on the ECU Club Channel. We'll be back right after this.
That's closer to my college GPA.
Pops that one up left side. And Stanisek calls everybody off, makes the grab. One away.
Good play there by Stanisek, battling the sun. That'll bring up the shortstop, number 18, Michael Weaver, batting 211 on the season. And then we'll flip it back to the top of the order.
Weaver will dig in from the left side. Righty-lefty matchup here as Wart looks in, gets his sign. He's got what he wants. He comes set. Pitch home. Drills that one deep to center field. Albert on the run. Or no, who made that catch there?
Second
that
Mason.
Was Mason Lee makes that grab.
Because
Albert wasn't going to get to that. Two away. And we'll pass the bat and flip it to the top of the lineup.
Jacob Annunziata, victim of a strikeout, his first at bat.
First pitch misses top upper part of the zone. 1-0 to count. Pitch home. Misses low and inside, 2-0. Two away here in the top of the third. Nobody on for the pack.
Tiffany must be multitasking. She says she'll see us soon. Hope you're not watching and driving, Tiffany. Pay attention to the roads.
In there for a strike, 2-1. Wart comes set, pitch home. Ropes that down the first baseline, foul. It's a good thing that was foul, too, because that had extra bases written all over it. That'll even the count. Two balls, two strikes.
Chris, what state has the smallest drink?
The smallest drink?
Yep.
I have no idea.
Minnesota.
right into the glove of Mason Lee for out number three. You worked hard on those while I was gone.
I told you I've been practicing.
We go to the bottom of the third. No score. The 0-1 offer. Fouls that one off and out of play. Finds himself in an 0-2 hole. Pitch home. Hits that one past the third baseman. Base hit.
Right through the 5-6 hole.
And that puts the leadoff batter on for the first time today for the Pirates. Or did, no, Rooster got on.
Yep.
I'm sorry.
It's going to bring up 9-hole hitter, second baseman, Mason Lee. Mason batting 226 on the year. Third baseman playing even with the bag, maybe expecting a bunt here. Now creeping in. Mason pops it up.
Back to us.
I will say Mason probably one of the better bunters on the team. I hope that's not announcer's jinx, but he normally does a pretty good job of getting it down here.
Way to go, Mike.
Yep, sorry. My bad.
Oh, on the count here. Runner at first. Pitch home. Shows bunt. Puts it down. He only plays at one. And he's on.
Not this time, Chris. Not this time.
And the Pirates with something cooking here in the bottom of the third. That'll bring up number 7. We go to the top of the lineup. Shortstop, Jay Stanisek.
Good bunt there by Lee. Hit right in front of the plate, went almost straight up in the air and to the Bermuda Triangle. Really nobody knew who to pick it up.
Going back to small ball, takes a strike. 0-1's the count.
Interesting. Always interesting to see how third baseman plays that. He's staying home there. So he's relying on the pitcher to cover the entire right side, third base side.
Shows bunt again, puts it down. That's a nice bunt. They're going to go to one with it. And that's going to pull him off the bag. And we got bases juiced.
Hit is
I think I should tell the guys there. They're waving high there. Bases juiced here, nobody out. Pirates threatening with number two, the center fielder, Will Albert, at the plate. Is that one in there for a ball?
Pirates load the bases by way of bunt or by base hit, bunt single, and then an error on an attempted bunt. Got to get at least one home.
Got the one at second. But that'll play to run. So we're going to imagine that's going to be a question for interference, I would imagine. And he slid right into the bag, second baseman there for the Wolfpack. It's tripped, and they're not going to give it to him.
It looks like he just slid and popped up. Nothing egregious there that I could tell. Does push one run across.
That'll bring up your left fielder, number five, Petey Fry. Looks down the third baseline. It's a sign from coach.
We mentioned Petey has a catalyst on the team. In limited at bats, he's hitting .647 on the year. Just an aggressive hitter that really hunts base hits.
Runners on the corners, one away. Pirates jump out in front as they strike first here. And fouls it straight back to us.
Good cut there.
0-1 to count.
See 46 of you watching out there, but we only have two likes. That might be because you hate the dad jokes and you have us on mute, but if not, we would appreciate an extension of that index finger. Hit that like button, hit that share button, hit that subscribe button. ECU Club Baseball would love your support.
The 0-1. Runner's gone. He'll reach on the defensive indifference. And that was a strike called, 0-2 the count.
And that was a tough one.
Yeah.
It's only one, though. It's only one.
One away, 0-2 the count. Stosky's got his pitch. Pitch home. Pops it up, fights it off.
Infield comes in now.
Two runners in scoring position. Got Lee at third, and is that Albert at second?
That is correct.
Fry at the plate, 0-2 offer. And hits it back right over to 5-6 hole. They're going to send the runner home, play at the plate. The throw is off. And a two-run RBI for Fry. And the Pirates jump out to a 3-0 lead here in the bottom of the third. Bottom of the third. That'll bring up your first baseman, Zach Rooster Nicholson. Time called. They're going to have a
pinch runner, looks like.
Yeah, first base coach was pointing at his side, so I don't know if that's still the injury suffering from a little bit there after that swing. That was a great hit right over the shortstop's head there. And that'll bring up number eight will take over the running duties for the Pirates at first base.
Will Atkins.
Rooster digs in from the right side.
Rooster, a solid single back up the middle his last time up.
That'll miss low and away. 1-0 to count as Rooster gets to work out in front. You have any plans after the game today?
I do.
Me too. I got to go file my taxes.
Is that a joke or is that
serious? No, I got to file my taxes.
I'm still waiting for something.
Pops that one up mile high. First baseman's going to try to range over, and that'll go out of play into the new bleachers here at the stadium.
I was waiting for the punchline.
No. I'm just wait till the extreme last minute to give Uncle Sam my money.
Since we don't do it all year long.
It's my favorite time of year. At least there's baseball.
At least there's baseball.
1-1 the count here. Runner at first. One away. Pitch home. Foul tipped.
Healthy cut there by Rooster.
Rooster swinging for the fences.
Swung
here.
Right through that one.
He'll dig back in a hole. 1-2 the count. Stosky's got a sign. Checks the runner at first. Comes set. Misses low and away. That'll even things up. 2-2.
Stosky going with almost like the football baseball pants. Chris, what's your opinion on the pants above the knee?
Well, my 13-year-old, that's about all he wears because he's built like me and looks like a tooth. He's the closest to a stick figure that you'll come to. Everything's too short for him because he's so tall. Drills that one deep, ranging back. It is gone. Two-run bomb by Zach Rooster Nicholson.
His second one on the series. Zach hit a grand slam yesterday. Having a really good series at the plate.
And he'll bring it in for a 5-run lead, and the Pirate Bats have gotten hot here in the bottom of the third. And that'll bring up the designated hitter, number 22, Shea Ward.
Now batting for the Pirates, the designated hitter, number 22, Shea Ward.
You know, in the back of Shea's mind, it's a replay of yesterday. Let's see what he can do here.
I think Rooster must have hit my center field camera. It's messing up again.
We'll blame it on him.
And comes up empty there on the low and inside. Shea digs back in from the left side. Stosky looks in to Wingard, gets his sign. He comes set. Nobody on, one away here in the bottom of the third. The 0-1 offer sails high. That'll even the count, 1-1.
Pirates can't take the foot off the gas here. Wolfpack, obviously a quality team, only in the third inning here. Really can't get complacent.
A lot of baseball to go. As he comes up empty there, 1-2.
I'd keep throwing that pitch till he shows he can lay off of it.
The 1-2 misses top part of the zone. That'll even things up. Two balls, two strikes.
He's been fastball up, breaking ball down. Fastball up, breaking ball down. Let's see if he continues that pattern.
Pitch on. Down the first baseline. Makes the dugout do some work over there.
Breaking ball down. Difference was he actually got a piece of that one.
And that's a pitch you'll get, what would you say, 95% of lefties to chase? That low inside. The 2-2. And goes down looking on an extremely low pitch. Well, you know what they say, the Masters. A tradition like no other.
A tradition like no other.
That'll bring up number 20, the catcher, Lee Parker. He digs in from the right side, two away here.
Lee, a K victim on three pitches the last at bat.
Just a bit inside as that one sails high.
You have the chance to see at least one more this at bat. Don't know how he laid off that one.
One ball, no strikes.
JJ, to answer your question, Rooster happened again.
Healthy cut comes up empty, foul tipped and two to Mitt. 1-1.
And Petey doing Petey things.
One ball, one strike, two away, nobody on. Bottom of the third. Right back up the middle, could be trouble, base hit. And Parker reaches first base. And the hits keep coming for the Pirates.
Pirates will bring their ninth batter to the plate. Right fielder, number 17, Hunter Zentz up the bat.
Zentz digs in. That'll catch the outer half for a strike. Giving that call all game.
It's not Angel Hernandez worthy, but it is a tad bit off.
The 0-1 offer. And hits that one in between the 5-6 hole. Back-to-back base hits. And Zins is on. That'll bring up number 35, the third baseman playing the hot corner, Colton Motes.
He started this off with a single as we headed into the bottom of the third inning.
Let's see if the center field camera's working now. Doesn't look like it. Looks like it's still freezing up on me. I'll try to work on it in between innings here. Pops out when foul and out of play.
Even though it's a five spot for the Pirates, still no work down in the Wolfpack bullpen. They seem like they're going to ride Ostoski here.
Runners at first and second, two away. 0-1 the count here to Motes. Healthy cut. Comes up empty. 0-2. Ostoski comes set, checks the runner, pitch home, hits it to the shortstop. He'll range across the field. Did he get the tag? Evidently not. He went back and touched the bag just to be safe. But, hey, Pirates plate five here in the bottom of the third. We go to the top of the fourth. Pirates with the lead. 5-0 your score here in Greenville. You're watching Pirate Baseball here on inside corner. That'll even count one.
It's the right fielder, our number 12, Jake Montgomery, up the bat. Jake, a victim of a hit by pitch, his first at bat.
Just a bit outside. 2-1 to count. And Warwick working fast here. 3-1 to count. That'll sail high. Ball four. And that'll put a Wolfpack runner on first.
Important for the Pirates here not to let the Wolfpack back in it after putting up a foul spot in the bottom half of this inning, the previous inning.
Nice breaking ball catches the outer half. 0-1.
It's first baseman Reese Landmark, hitting 314 on the season. Again, Reese is the one with the big three-run home run yesterday, so certainly a guy you want to be careful with here.
Pick attempt over to first, more just to let him know he was paying attention to him. Swing and a miss, 0-2 to count.
Nice off-speed there by Zach. Well ahead here.
And picks back over to first, in and out of the glove of a rooster.
Picks here at Guy Smith always scare me because if it gets by Rooster, a lot of foul ground here.
The 0-2 offer. Fouls that one off. No balls, two strikes. Runner at first. Pirates looking for their first out here in the top of the fourth. Pitch home. Comes up empty.
Good off speed there by Wart. It's going to bring up the DH number 15. Reed Richards, also a K victim, his first at bat.
Runner with his lead at first, one away. Wart's got his sign. Pick attempt to first. Again, in and out of the glove there. Like you said, a lot of room on the foul lines here. A lot of construction going on here at Guy Smith.
Montgomery looked like he was leaning a little bit.
And he's gone. Fouls off. They got a little bit of help there as that'll send him back to first. Even the count.
He finally realizes it. ECU told him it was a foul ball. He's like, nope, I'm not falling for that one. I'm going to get to hear from the umpire. I know how you fools are.
Yeah, my third base camera got messed up here. I'll have to get a check on that here in a minute.
Chris, you talk about the construction. Reason for that is Guy Smith will be hosting Coastal Plain Summer League team this year, the Greenville Yard Gnomes.
The 1-1 and fouls that one off. That'll work to count 1-2.
Coastal Plain League, Woodbat Summer Collegiate League here. That Greenville is certainly excited to have Greenville known as a baseball community.
Pick a tent back over to first again. Runner's gone. Hits over to Stanisek. Fires to first for the out. Two away here in Greenville. And let me see, who's number 17 in left field over there for us?
Hunter Zents.
So Fry must be injured again.
Zents moves to the left. Will Atkins takes over in right. This will bring up Jonathan Constantino, the left fielder for the Wolfpack.
Drops in there for a strike. That was a nice breaking ball.
Very nice breaking ball by Zach.
Checks the runner at second. Second baseman bounces off. The 0-1 just misses top part of the zone. That'll even things up. One ball, one strike.
Zach a little frustrated with himself there.
At 52, 53 pitches here. Pitch home.
That's a great spot right there. Wow.
That missed somewhere. 2-1 the count. Ward's got his sign, the 2-1 offer. Nice breaking ball. That drops right in there. And that'll even the count. Two balls, two strikes, two outs. Runner at second. Deuces wild. Top of the fourth. Runner's gone. Tapper down to third baseline. Foul. That will send him back to second. And bless his heart, he's... I'd show you the play at third, but this is the third base camera at the moment.
Wow.
Yeah, somebody bumped my camera over there in the dugout. I'll have to go there. I'll fix it in between innings. It's a good shot up left field, though.
Absolutely.
Two balls, two strikes, pitch home. Drills that one deep left center. Albert on the run. That's going to be over his head. That's going to plate one for the Wolfpack. Throw into second. Good throw. And a stand-up double puts the Wolfpack on the board. 5-1 your score here in the top of the fourth. Two away.
Yeah, good swing there by Constantino on a hanging breaker. Drove it out over the center fielder's head. It's going to bring up the catcher, number 14, Jack Wingard for the Wolfpack. K. Vick in his first time up.
Am I dropping money?
I think so.
It's considered a tip.
Don't eat yellow snow.
That'll miss for a ball. 1-0 the count. The 1-0. Just missed off the plate. Mark, I don't think like that he didn't get that one. I'll move to count, two balls, no strikes.
Well, once the umpire establishes the zone, you hope he keeps that zone throughout the game. Looks like it's moving a little bit this inning.
Nice breaking ball. Drops in there for a strike.
Didn't like that pitch there. Lee wanted the pickoff at second base. It really exposed that right side there. Thankfully, the batter didn't take advantage.
Time called in the box. Two, one. Nice pitch in the side. Catches the corner. We'll do it again. Two balls, two strikes, two outs.
This is where he hung one to Constantino. Let's see what he can do here with Wingard.
Fouls that back and out of play.
Good pitch there. Just got spoiled.
Pitch home. Right into the glove. And he'll toss it over to first. Four out number three. They push one across. 5-1 the new score here in Greenville. We go to the bottom of the fourth. You're watching Pirate Baseball here on the ECU Club Channel. We'll be back right after this.
Welcome back, Pirate fans. The Wolfpack were able to scratch across one in the top of the fourth inning there. That brings our score to 5-1. Your Pirates leading, heading into the bottom of the fourth inning here, and we will lead off with the nine-hole hitter, second baseman, Mason Lee.
So the Pirates lead cut to 4.
Seven, Jay Stanisic is up the bat.
And that'll get through the shortstop and bounce off the third baseman. If they're making their turn, he'll come home and plate. So Stanisic, how do we score that? A single with an error?
Yeah, absolutely. It's going to be a triple in the ECU club scoreboard, I guarantee. And that's all right. Hot start here to the bottom of the fourth inning for the Pirates. Single two-base error, runner on third base, no outs, and the run already in. So the Pirates have already got that run back that they gave up in the top of the fourth and a chance to do some more damage.
That'll bring up the center fielder number 2, Will Albert. Digs in from the left side. He's got another Pirate 90 feet away. 6-1 the score here in Greenville. Ropes that one down the first baseline. That'll plate another run. He's thinking too. He'll hold up at first. And just like that, the Pirates plate 2 here in the bottom of the fourth. Nobody out, and looks like we're going to have time called here. And the Wolfpack does have action going in the bullpen. Looks like we may have a change here.
Yeah, looks like they're not going to waste any time here.
As the Wolfpack are still having their talk out there, don't know if we're going to go to the bullpen yet or not. And the umpire will make his way out to break it up. Looks like we are going to have a change here. So Ostoski's day is done. We'll let you know who the new pitcher is when we come back. You're watching Pirate Baseball here on the ECU Club Channel. We'll be back right after this.
Welcome back, club baseball fans. The new pitcher for the Wolfpack is number 30, Carson King. Carson with a 0-0 record, 12 innings pitched, 1.17 ERA, and 10 strikeouts in 12 innings. Rudely greeted on the first pitch by Will Atkins, who sends a shot down to the third baseman. Great job by Chadwick down there to keep it in front of him, but just couldn't get it across the diamond in fast enough to get Atkins. That's going to bring up Zach Rooster Nicholson, who hit a ball in the last inning that I don't think has landed yet.
Yeah, I think Zach's the reason we don't have a center field camera at the moment, because it just quit working after that. Two runners on, nobody out here in the bottom of the fourth. They've already plated two. That one sails high and inside. Both runners take off. And Rooster did not like that pitch. And that'll send the catcher out to settle down his pitcher. Zach digs back in. One ball, no strikes. Two runners in scoring position for the Pirates. That'll catch the outer half. Four strikes, says Blue. 1-1. Pitch home. Not way too much in the other batter's box. 2-1 to count.
Yeah, that's the Angel Hernandez territory there.
That's a good frame by the catcher. I like it.
He did. He tried his best.
I'm partial to catchers. The 2-1. Sells high.
Have you seen one where the kid's got to be like 10 years old and it's the pitch home and he jumps and grabs
it? Yeah, and pulls it back.
And looking back at umpire like, bro, what's wrong?
I framed it perfectly.
Yeah.
The 3-1. And that'll miss the top part of zone. Rooster will draw the base on balls and bases are juiced for the designated hitter, number 22, Shea Ward.
Shea with a fly out the center and a K looking, his first two at-bats today. Really opportunity. Really, he's just looking to do a job.
And it's hard when you get a hit parade going like this. You know, all you want to do is put the ball in play. Bases juiced, pitched home, sails high, 1-0 to count.
That could have easily been a balk call there. I don't believe Carson ever came set.
That'll catch the lower part of the zone, low and away for a strike. Evens count, 1-1. Asks for the sign again, he's got what he wants. Pitch home. That drops in there for a strike. Shea's looking for something particular. Hadn't got what he wants yet, the 1-2 offer. And goes down looking low and away. One away. That'll bring up the catcher, number 20, Lee Parker.
Same thing here for Lee, right? Have a job to do here. Swing the bat. Let's get the ball in play. Preferably a fly ball to the outfield to score that runner from third base.
Pops it foul and out of play. 0-1 to count. You know how you know you're old.
I look in the mirror.
My mom used to keep Lee when he was little at her daycare. That'll miss outside. I thought the name sounded familiar. I didn't realize that. 1-1 the count, one away, bases juiced. Right into shortstop, throw across the plate. They get the out, but played
okay.
A run.
Drove the run in. Drove the run in.
So a job done. They grab one more. 8-1 your score here in Greenville. That'll put runners at second and third and bring up number 17, Hunter Zents. Left fielder coming in for Fry after his injury at the plate. Looked like he re-injured himself on the solid hit. His last at bat, that misses the top part of the zone. 1-0 is the count. That'll catch the outer half for a strike. That'll even the count. 1-1, two away, two runners on. Wolfpack trying to leave them stranded. Pirates trying to push them across. Pitch home. Just missed the top part of the zone. 2-1's the count. King's got his sign. Pitch home. Pops that one up. Center fielder will range to his left and make the grab for out number three. But not without the Pirates pushing some more across. We go to the top of the fifth. 8-1 your score here in Greenwood.
Third baseman, Chadwick Carpenter. Nice play there by Colton, coming in and getting that ball, making a strong throw across the diamond. Hit Rooster right in the chest.
So far, one up, one down. In there for a strike, 0-1 the count. Nice pitch, that catches. The 0-2 offer. Right field pops it up. Could be trouble. Great grab by Mason Lee there at second. Two away.
I'm sorry, it's Mason Lee. You think Roy had this stuff written down, right? Number 18, Michael Weaver at the plate.
Now batting for the Wolfpack, number 18, Michael Weaver. He'll take a strike on the outer half.
Wolfpack 9-hole hitter. Warwick doing a very good job here, filling up the strike zone, getting ahead of batters. Really good pace.
That'll miss, low and away. Shortstop to first. 1-2-3. Go the Wolfpack. We go to the bottom of the fifth. 8-1 your score. You're watching Pirate Baseball.
Wolfpack fans are watching the broadcast as well. How about let us know where you're watching from?
That'll drive just over the second baseman, Mason Bay, as he laid out for it, just couldn't come up with it.
Hit it where they ain't. Mason Lee, the second baseman, up to bat now. Two singles on the day.
Sells high and inside for a ball. 1-0 is the count. And the 1-0 offer. This is low and away. 2-0 to count. Wolfpack does have some action going in their bullpen.
As does the Pirates.
Sells high and inside. 3-0.
Last I checked, I think Warwick was at 72 pitches, so creeping on up there.
He's pitched a great game thus far.
He has pitched a fabulous game thus far.
King asked for a new sign, 3-0 the count, pitch hold. That'll drop in there for the ceremonial 3-0 strike one. And he'll wear that one off the shoulder. So a hit by pitch will put runners at first and second.
Mason on all three at bats this game. Let's bring up the shortstop. Number 7, Jay Stanisek. Stanisek with a single himself. Last time he was up the bat.
Drills that one deep into center field. Off the fence. Runners had to tag, so that's going to keep everybody going base to base. Great hit.
Stanisek is like, what are y'all doing? I smoked that one. You're not used to that power from you, Jay.
And the one time I smoke a ball. That one did actually hit the camera or hit the fence where the camera is, and maybe it'll knock it into working.
It's going to bring up Will Albert with the bases loaded. Albert a single his last time up.
Bases juice, nobody out. First pitch in there for strike, lower part of the zone. 0-1 the count. Pitch home. Breaking ball stayed high. Just missed the top part of the zone. That'll even the count. 1 ball, 1 strike. Is there anything more, I don't know if you say American or baseball-ish or whatever, than having the Waffle House right beside the stadium that you can see?
Just to tease you.
That one misses the top part of the zone, 2-1.
I don't know. I'm kind of partial to one that you really can't see. You're blocked by the first dugout.
Ropes that one over the second baseman. That's going to roll to the fence. That's going to play one, play two. That's going to clear the bases. And a 3 RBI double for Will Albert. And that'll push it out to a 10-spot lead. 11-1 your score here in the bottom of the fifth. That'll send the coach out to the mound. And looks like we may be having a change here.
Just to finish that thought, kind of partial to a local establishment, Ernie's Famous.
Ernie's,
subs.
Yes.
The wind blows right. It will really make you hungry.
All right. Base is cleared. Runner at second. 11-1 your score. We go to take a break. We'll let you know who the new pitcher is for the Wolfpack when we come back. You're watching Pirate Baseball here on the ECU Club Channel. We'll be back right after this.
Welcome back, Pirate fans. The new pitcher for the Wolfpack is number 16, Alex Manuel. 1-0 record and 4.2 innings pitched. Has a 9 ERA, but has struck out 11 batters of the 14 outs he has gotten. He'll face off here against Will Atkins, who went in as a sub for Petey Fry. And Will takes the first pitch curveball off the outside corner for ball one.
One out to count here. Pitch home. Just a bit outside. 2-0 to count.
Chris, you can never have enough. 11-1, bottom of the fifth inning. Do you lay down a bunt here to move that runner to third, or is that one of those unwritten rules?
As that one missed the top part of the zone, I don't know. Got a little chippy in the, what would you say, bottom of the third?
Yeah.
For a moment, umpires quelled that pretty quickly. Two very competitive teams. And that'll miss ball four. And he'll take the walk down the first baseline.
It's going to bring up the first baseman, Zach Rooster Nicholson. Zach with a single, a home run, and a walk in his three ABs on the day. Came in batting 295. That will certainly go up after today.
Runners at first and second, nobody out. Runners gone. Throw down to third, and that'll get past the third baseman and play to run on the error. Would you say throw or catch?
I didn't see the throw very well. Threw it in the dirt. Third baseman made some good plays down there, but that was a tough pick.
And consequently, runner at first stayed. He did not follow on the throw. So runner at first, 12-1 your score here in Greenville. One ball, no strikes to Rooster. Long look in. Nice breaking ball drops in there for a strike. That'll even count one ball, one strike. Pirates, if you can believe it, what's on the board with 15 hits, 12 runs. Breaking ball gets away from the catcher, misses way outside.
The Pirates are not bunting, but still have the foot on the gas. Going to take every opportunity.
Atkins at second. Two balls, one strike. Long looks. He takes a look at Atkins at second. Second baseman bouncing off. And that sails high and inside. 3-1 to count. Wind blowing directly out to center. And a 3-1 offer. And time called. Yeah, he's taking a long time with each pitch. We'll set it back up. Three balls, one strike. Runner in scoring position for the Pirates. Pitch home. Breaking ball. Misses the top part of the zone. Ball four. That'll bring up the designated hitter, number 22, Shea Ward.
Shea struggled with the at-bats today. Fly out to center field and 2 Ks looking. No, he's going to look for something to drive here.
Shea digs in from the left side. Righty-lefty matchup here. Nobody out. Runners at first and second. Breaking ball just missed the outer half. 1-0's the count.
Manuel's got a good one. He's just hanging outside a little bit. You see the ECU hitters giving up on it early. Saw Zach duck out of the way a couple of times.
1-0. Drills that one deep into right field. Right fielder ranges back, makes the grab. Zach advances on the sack. That'll put runners on the corners. With one away.
Productive bring, out, though.
Go ahead.
Productive out, though, moving a runner there from second to third.
And that'll bring up the catcher, number 20, Lee Parker. One away, runners on the corners. Rooster takes off, and he'll get a stolen base on the defensive indifference.
It's those wheels you were talking about.
Yeah. Unhook that trailer and take off. And time called.
Looks like that last curveball might have hurt Manuel a little bit.
Yeah, not sure if he finished. He came up a little gingerly there. And that's going to be it for him. We're going to have another pitching change here in Greenville. 12-1 your score. We'll let you know who the new pitcher is when we come back. You're watching Pirate Baseball here on the ECU Club Channel. We'll be back right after this.
Welcome back. Fans of the new pitcher for the Wolfpack, number 25, Nate Johnson. A 1-1 record on the year, 11 innings pitched, 1.27 ERA, and 5 Ks.
That first pitch fouled off. Off the catcher's mask there. That evens the count, 1-1. Hopefully Manuel's okay. Like I said, it looked like he come up a little ginger after that curve. Better to be cautious than not. Runners at second and third, one away. 1-1. Pitch home. Sells inside, just didn't miss hitting him. 2-1 the count. Again, apologize for not having the center field camera. It's having a mind of its own today. The 2-1. Fouls that off. That'll even the count, 2-2. It's been a while. Welcome everybody in for watching. If you'd like to, check in, let us know where you're watching from, who you're pulling for. Wolfpack or Pirate, or any other team, just scoping out the game. The 2-2 offer. Sells high, and that'll work to count full. Pops it up. Shortstop ranges back. Says he's got it. He'll put it away for out number two.
Just going to bring up your right fielder, number 17, Hunter Zintz.
So with two away and runners at second and third. Johnson looks in, gets his sign, comes set. Pitch home. Nice off speed. Hunter comes up empty. He was swinging for the fence on that one.
Hunter does have two home runs on the year.
The 0-1. That bottom fell out of that one, comes up empty. 0-2 to count.
Yeah, Johnson's really got Hunter fooled on these first two pitches.
No balls, two strikes, two outs. Pitch home. That'll miss inside. 1-2 is the count. Pitch home. Drills that one right side. Right fielder will make a couple moves to his right and put it away for out number three. The Pirates leave two stranded, but they played four. We go to the top of the sixth. 12-1 your score here in Greenville. You're watching Pirate Baseball. And that'll miss low. 1-1's the count. So I told you I was DJing that wedding last night. I rented a limousine to take my wife to the wedding with me. But it didn't come with a driver. All that money and nothing to show for it. That one misses 2-1 to count. We're watching replays here of the big team as they're underway. Just down the road at Cart LeClaire as that one misses outside, 3-1. Pitch home. That'll grab the outer half. That'll work the count full. Warwick pitching at Jim so far today was 77 pitches. The payoff pitch gets him to chase. Comes up empty. One away.
It's going to bring up the right fielder, number 12, Jake Montgomery. Jake drew a base on balls his last at bat.
That'll catch the outer half for a strike. Back-to-back strikes. That one's still in the outer half, not quite down the middle. Good pitch nonetheless. Let's see what he goes with on the 0-2 here. Tried the corner and missed. Tried to catch just off the plate there to see if he could get him to chase it. Lays off of it. The 1-2. Nice breaking ball. Fights it away to stay alive. And he'll fight that one away as well. The 1-2. Pops it up and out of play. Count remains 1-2.
Pirates do have somebody down there in the bullpen, but again, currently just lightly tossing.
And he'll take a hit by a pitch there as he loses him. And that'll put a Wolfpack runner on base here with one away in the top of the sixth. Today, a 9-inning game here in Greenville.
It's going to be the first baseman, number 26, Reese Landmark, up the bat.
First pitch just missed, 1-0 to count.
Mentioned this game is scheduled to be 9 innings. I'm not sure if there's a run rule involved or not.
Drills that one deep. That'll send Albert back about 10 steps. He'll make the grab on the warning track. Two away. So with two away, that'll bring up number 15.
The DH, Reed Richards. Grounded out to shortstop his last time at bat.
Right back up the middle, Mason will toss to Stanisek. Four out, number 3. They leave one stranded. We go to the bottom of the sixth. 12-1 your score here in Greenville. You're watching Pirate Baseball here on the Knock on wood. Going to cooperate, so we'll go back to it here. The 0-1. Tap down the third baseline. That'll go harmlessly foul and out of play. And that'll make the count 0-2. The 0-2 offer. Misses in the dirt. One ball, two strikes. As the Pirates are sending some more down to their bullpen. The 1-2. Check swing, says he went. One away. That'll bring up the second baseman, number 3, Mason Lee. That'll miss, kick away.
Hey, Chris, did you hear about the pilot who threw his clock?
The what?
The pilot.
Pilot who that threw his clock, yeah. No.
You want to see time fly?
The 1-0. Taps it down to third base side.
Good play.
Fires across the field. Two away.
Good play by the third baseman there. Really backing up. That second hop can be tricky. Strong throw across the diamond to get the out.
And that'll bring up number 7, Stanisek. He'll dig in from the right side. Two-way, nobody on here in the bottom of the 6th. Pops it up. First baseman arranging over to make the grab. And he'll put it away in foul territory for out number 3. First inning since the 2nd. The Pirates don't put any runs up. We go to the top of the 7th. 12-1 your score here in Greenville. You're away.
who has moved in to play right field, and Richard Warren taking over at first base.
First pitch fouled off. Second one comes back with a letters high heater. 0-2 to count as he comes up empty. And says that one misses. The 1-2. Foul tipped into the mitt. One away.
It's going to bring up the catcher, number 14, and Jack Wingard.
Eating ready to go here. Nice pitch in there for a strike. I just realized I did not zoom in the center field camera enough. A little far off.
Working again?
Yep. Yeah. Find some wood.
Does the head count?
Bounds that one off. 0-2 to count. Got the pitch he wants. Pitch home. Just missed the lower part of the zone.
They can't say enough about the job by Zach Wark coming into a rubber match of this series and really shutting down a powerful Wolfpack squad.
He fouls that one back. One ball, two strikes, one away, nobody on. Pitch home. Sells high and inside. That'll even it up, 2-2. What's the big club looking like here?
Currently down 2-0 in the bottom of the third inning.
Comes up empty, blows it by, 2-away.
Typical what you see. They've really handled Charlotte the first couple of games of this series. Coming into the third game, tend to relax a little bit and see if Cliff can give them a kick in the pants and get them started.
So two away here in the top of the seventh, 12-1 your score. Eaton comes set and delivers. Breaking ball catches the inside for a strike.
This is the second baseman, Mason Bay, up the bat.
The 0-1. Foul tips that one off.
Mason, the ground ball to third, his last at bat.
Shakes off his first signs, likes what he's got now. The 0-2 offer. Just missed the top part of the zone. The 1-2. That'll miss outside. Two balls, two strikes, two outs. Deuces wild, top of the seventh. Nobody on. Pitch home. That'll miss in the dirt.
On every pitch, the ECU dugout's ready to come out and congratulate him on a third strike. Then have to turn around and go back in.
Full count, payoff pitch. Could be trouble. Over to first. Got him. 1-2-3. Go the Wolfpack.
And that answers the question.
That